how to create value in a project in a dynamic environment. Please let me give you the example of the following project in the Netherlands, the A2 Maastricht. Maastricht is a city in the southeast of our country. Through the eastern part of the city runs the busy highway A2. At both sides of the highway, people live closely to this highway. In fact, the highway divides the city into two parts and creates unacceptable levels of air pollution and noise. For decades, there have been plans to bring the highway underground by means of creating a tunnel at the current location, but sufficient support and funding were lacking. Apparently, this solution was too costly for the value it created. Another solution was to bring the highway outside the city, eastward. This solution was not feasible because it would cross a valuable nature area and led to much opposition of people living there. Moreover, too much traffic on the highway has a destination Maastricht. So one way or the other, a link with the city needed to be created in this solution. From these two potential solutions, still the most attractive solution was a tunnel. But there was a need to create more value for the money invested. At the beginning of the 21st century, this solution was found by reframing the overall plan. Until then, the project was dominantly an infrastructure project, focusing on congestion and the need to increase traffic flow. The extra value was found in transferring the project from an infrastructure project to a city development project. Hence, increasing the scope of the project and increasing its overall complexity. By doing so, the earlier mentioned tunnel solution became feasible. For those who are interested, some technical details about the final solution. It was decided to create a double-deck tunnel. The upper part is for local traffic in the city, and the lower part is for traffic that doesn't have the destination Maastricht. This double-deck tunnel has sufficient capacity for the cars and lorries. And specifically for the civil engineers among you, interesting is that this is the first double-deck tunnel in the Netherlands. This is a costly solution, and without creating extra value, this solution could never have been built. How did they find the extra value to make the plan feasible? The extra value was found by bringing the highway underground in a tunnel. In several ways, extra value can be created on ground level. Firstly, the space of the old highway comes available for other functions. Plans have been made for real estate development, offices and apartment buildings. Depending on the market, in total 1,000 new apartments and a maximum of 30,000 square meters of extra commercial real estate will be realized up to 2026. This city development contributes financially to the infrastructure to make the project feasible. A major part of the new space that is created by bringing the highway underground was designed as a green zone that has been generating extra support for the project. The project is named after this green zone, the green carpet. This will give the area an environmental upgrade. And of utmost importance, by bringing the highway in the tunnel, the city will be healed. To complete the feasibility of the project, the province and the cities of Maastricht and Meersen also financially contributed to the project, approximately 1/5 of the public funding. Of course, there were threats to overcome, such as the technical risks at the design and construction of the double-deck tunnel, and the financial risks of the real estate. Finally, these risks have been mitigated and the tunnel was opened in December 2016. Wasn't this solution possible some decades ago? In other words, why did it take so long before finding and realizing this solution? I am convinced that this solution was not possible in the previous century. The solution found was very much a solution that fits in the current time frame. Let me give three reasons for this. Firstly, the reframing to a city development project marks a change in thinking and practicing over the years. Traditionally, the dominant function to focus at was traffic. But over the years, livability becomes more and more important as a value. That was important in gaining support for this plan. Secondly, the addition of scope. The idea that real estate can financially contribute to an infrastructure project is relatively new in the Netherlands. The first project in this way of public-private partnership has been realized at the beginning of the century. Thirdly, traditionally, the central government was responsible for highway projects, planning, funding, and realizing. Only recently, this kind of projects is co-initiated and co-funded by regional governments. This was also an incentive for the Minister of Infrastructure to give extra money to encourage other regional governments to contribute to highway projects elsewhere in the country. Interesting is that in this project, the project director wasn't a civil servant from the central government as usual, but the former director of the city development of the city of Maastricht. It is interesting that because of problems with the financial feasibility of the project, creativity has been stimulated to find extra value. That is what we can also see at other projects that have a main financial challenge. People came up with new, attractive solutions and packages that will generally not be found in projects with sufficient funding. Apparently, financial tension can be a stimulus to come up with new solutions. To conclude our case of the A2 Maastricht, green carpet, you see that dynamics in society gave room to reframe the project and to add extra scope. Rather than reducing complexity, in fact, this project's complexity was enlarged. Reframing and adding of scope created extra value and made the broader city development project feasible by gaining sufficient political and societal support.